All right, today is kind of a funny one. I'm going through miscellaneous pottery, and I'm finding, my gosh, what a talented family! What a talented family! My brothers are all extremely talented in pottery, so I wanted to enlighten you and show you a bit of it before maybe they give up on it as an interrupt in their life and they just want to throw it in the trash. But there's something, I don't know, adhering and temptatious in the quality. They're absolutely skilled at what they do. And so it's kindish and yet in many respects absolutely professional. So I'm sending this one out there on a schism that perhaps one of them does want to become a potter and open a studio because there is a talent from all three of them. So here we have this is a cute little it's just a gadget case, and they're all glazed beautifully, and then it has the lid, so you have the lids. It's very important. And so all of these are wonderful, wonderful little ta-da, And it's like, why buy from the store? Once you have the pottery, why buy from the store? You already have it. Okay, now that was from the great artist of John. Now here we have, oh my goodness. Yeah, he's a sculptor also. I know I've said he's not being very artistic at the moment, but he is a sculptor. I wish he would endeavor it all the time. This is a flower pot of his. It is just incredible. I wish you could see the work of it, And so this was all done as a little child. So it's in yellow and blue. And this type of thing, I guess you use for erasers or pens or pencils or something. But what a talented individual. Yeah, he makes the sculpture of the body form. He went to San Francisco Graphic Art Institute, I believe it's called. It's a major, major school of the arts here in California and in the world. So here we have next. Oh my gosh, we have this one from René the Great, which is quite incredible. Yeah, René the Great itself, the fact that he even used that name. I have not seeked back with genealogy there to see if we are the great, but chances are. But this one's interesting because it has the more of a, what do we call it? It has that bump. It has that bump effect on the outside, so it's got quite a bit of texture. And I believe, and then the glazed inside. Much of these glazes, I'm sure, are leaded and you can't eat out of from them, but they're so beautiful, aren't they? Some of the lead glazes are so attractive. I don't know if you're going to use the lead glazes here in the United States any longer, but yeah. In continuing, this one's up for grabs. There is no name. There's no label. I'm not sure who did it, but it is a whale. Somebody's whale, and I'm not sure this is going to show well on the. Here it is, the whale. No, you cannot tell, but yeah. Anyway, so there is a whale, and I'm not sure which of my brothers, but I believe it was a time of smoking. So you put the cigarette in the whale's mouth, and then up through the spout. Or you can use it for incense also. You can use it for incense. So you could put the incense stick there, or a cone, and then the up goes through the spout, goes the smoke. So it can be used as an incense holder. So don't give up on that, if you're raced out of not sure what to do here. Now this was a gift to the father. This one. Look at the glaze on the inside, a nice beautiful light, and then on the outside. Gosh dang it, I wish my camera could detail it better. Oh, there, that maybe higher is better. But yeah. So that's kind of fun. That's kind of a fun one. So yeah, just simple little bowls. And now here's a vase. Now this is, to me, I don't know, we're getting more and more. I didn't want to go that far yet. But then here is a cow. Or a pig. It could be a pig. A cow or a pig. I'm not sure. Yeah, it could be a pig. Has the curly tail. So many animals. Yeah. Many animals. A scary pig there. But yeah, it doesn't look great right there. Oh my gosh. This one maybe. Now we have. I believe this is from Renee also. This one is a rooster, a cockerel. And so that's something interesting. I'm not really sure. I believe it could be used or fashioned for a bookcase eventually. That was the plan. Now, one of my brothers went, because I had a rabbit named Flopsy, so one of my brothers made this, I believe, is a gift for me. It is a rocks. Now, this is just painted rocks. A little Flopsy. So, yeah, who did the painted rock Flopsy? I'm not sure. I'm going to say it was Renee. But yeah, it is a great piece. Even has a little tail in the back, you know, of the rabbit, and it's all rocks. Yeah, so painted rock Flopsy. So thank you for the present, but I guess I'm gonna give it back. Now this here, well, wait, I'm not done. I'm not done. I have the younger brother, the most my youngest brother. Now here is his. I don't have much of his pottery, so it's quite young. The bee wind coil. He's just working with the coil, but I'm pretty sure he's proud of this also. But yeah, that was done at his very young age. Now this one also is Renee's. Renee was the talented one. Looking, it looks like he's the most talented at it, but in retrospect, he was older. So be fair, he was the older one taking the pottery classes before the institute shut down. We had our institute, our art institute in the neighborhood shut down completely. So we weren't allowed to make pottery any longer. So it was a tragedy because we were going to continue. We were going to keep going to classes and keep going to classes and keep going to classes. But somebody put an end to stop to it. And they actually dismantled the building. They took the building away completely. The one that we were making the pottery in. So it was kind of like not only do the pottery classes stop, we are going to take away the building that you're making the pottery in. It was an old wood building. It was a historical. And they just turned it into modern yuck. So anyway, here we go. This is another one of fine fashions from Renee, the potter. So yeah, what a talented group. And I'm not done with Renee's. I'll finish with John's because it's kind of funny. But this one is just more. What do you call it? Basic, your basic have to. This is when Rene was just, my gosh, and he worked on cars. He should have never done that. He should have just stayed with the pottery. But they took his building away, didn't they? So yeah, absolutely talented, and it kept going and kept going. He made love jugs. He did all kinds of things. I'm not showing everything here. I don't have everything. But yeah, what a talented individual. So there he goes. And then what else? No, I'm gonna finish this one with the already known sculptor, the one who did go to art school, professional, extra. And this one was John. And now John is here. Now if you can see. Oh gosh. If you can see, he's got dinosaur. He's got the dinosaurs. He has four different dinosaurs here, all on one plate. So it's kind of interesting how you he has the different styles of dinosaur, the different names, like the Diplodocus. No, that's a Stegosaur. He has the T-Rex, and then he has another one there. I'm not even sure what that one is. And then he has a little baby one down there. So yeah. Gosh dang it. Actually, this is the funniest one for me, is the dinosaur plate. A plate of dinosaurs, and then there's even the hidden egg. So it's kind of, it's one of those pieces that you just want to sit there in the middle of the table and just go, wow, it's way cool. So yeah, my talented brothers. And isn't that strange and odd? There we are, we're just getting more and more talented. And, you know, about ready to launch a pottery business, and they just take the building away. It's almost like, what? Fine arts? Cultural arts? Any type of arts? No, you're damned away from it. So yeah, shame on them. Shame on them when they did that. Anyway, so back to the little cutes. The little cutesies. I know, everybody just wants this, but it's not always that way.